You live in this time-space reality, and law of attraction is managing everything around you. So if you have some momentum going that is causing you to feel some negative emotion, you're not going to stop it all of a sudden, because law of attraction will not allow it. Whatever you've got going on vibrationally, the law of attraction is bringing you more of. So law of attraction works tremendously to your advantage and tremendously to your disadvantage, because it responds to whatever it is you've got active within you. But it also responds to whatever your inner being has going on actively too. For example, if life has caused you to want more prosperity, your inner being is focused upon that prosperity, and not just believing it, but knowing it absolutely. So as your inner being is focused upon the prosperity that you've carved out and asked for, if you're focused for some reason on some event that makes you feel shortage consciousness, then there is a vibrational variance right here, right now, on the same subject, because your inner being believes, knows your financial abundance, and right now you don't. And you're feeling the negative emotion that is evidence to you of how much your inner being believes. Did you like the way we said that? That's evidence of how much your inner being believes. It's also evidence of how much you don't believe, but that's not the part we want you to focus upon. We want you to focus upon how much your inner being believes in your autonomy, in your prosperity, in your ability to thrive on your own. Because each of you are extensions of source energy, and source energy is raining down around you and upon you and for you on your behalf, blessings of indescribable proportion and nature. And if you're not realizing them fully, it means you've got some shortage consciousness going on in your point of view, which we understand why you would, because you've been looking at what is, looking at what is, looking at what is. Oh, things move forward so much more slowly than they need to. You could clean up your vibration and shorten that gap of manifestation. And we wish that for you. We don't want you to wait so long for something that it's hard to remember how much you want it. We don't want your desires to feel like disappointment to you. We want them to feel like the fresh idea that they felt like when they first occurred to you in the beginning. So, very briefly, we want to remind you that you were source energy before you came into this physical body. And even though a portion of your consciousness is projected here into the personality that you know as you, the larger part of you still remains non-physically focused and holds a vivid personal perspective of you and yours. So here you are in this physical body, doing what you came to, out here on the leading edge, sifting and sorting and coming to your personal important preferences about what you want. So you know what you don't want, and you know what you do want, and you know what you don't want, and you know what you do want, and you know what you do want, and you know what you don't want. And you're carving out of this contrasting experience your idea of how life would be better for you. And so you are creating, adding to this vibrational reality, and the source within you loves the ideas that you are sending forth and stands in the vibrational beingness of every evolutionary idea that you flow forth. So here's this vibrational version of you. It's so real, we wanted you to know that it is real. We gave it a name, we called it the vortex. The vortex of creation, wrote a whole book about it, because we want you to come to understand and believe in this vibrational reality as much, no, even more than you believe in the reality that you can see and hear and smell and taste and touch. Because you got to know that life has caused you to create this. And it is a reality that your inner being knows and bees. So now we want to ask you a question. You have not heard us ask this question before, because we have not asked it of you before. So since this vortex exists, and since your inner being is standing right in the middle of it, what do you think it feels like to your inner being to stand in the middle of what you've created? Proud. Excited, exhilarated, interested, eager, and happy for you to begin your personal now realization of the details and the unfolding of what you've put together. Now, you can't even describe it very well, because you've been putting pieces of it in there for such a long time, and you don't even realize how perfectly the pieces that you've been asking for all fit with one another. So there is a reality that's been forming that, when you allow it, will surprise and delight you beyond our ability to describe it to you verbally. But it is gestating and it is growing, and law of attraction is responding to it. Can you feel that law of attraction is responding to it? And as it grows and becomes and matures and exists, can you sort of get a feeling of your relationship with it? Can you feel how, as it is growing and expanding and becoming, can you feel how you, in your personality, in your human personality, have a relationship with it? Are you looking forward to it? Are you eager about it? Are you looking forward to the realization of it? Can you find the feeling of it? So as you hang around in more good feeling vibrations, as you meditate more and quiet your mind and therefore release all resistant thought, as you make lists of appreciation, and as you get out more, as you spend more time outside, as you move your body more and you drink more water and you just get feeling better and spend more time with people that are nice to be with and do the things that make you feel good, stop watching the news on television, stop trying to solve the problems of the world, just live in your own life and get to yourself a little more and allow your natural cork to float. It will, if you won't hold it under the water when you let go, right back up there where you belong in the good feeling vibration. So as you're doing more and more of that, frequently, because you'll be in that vibrational vicinity of where your vortex is, ideas will flow from that vortex right into your head. You'll realize something. You'll get an idea about something. You say, oh, I know what I want. I know what I want. And when that occurs, that means that there is a seamless transfer. This is thoughts turning to things. That's what's happening. Thoughts turning to things. But thoughts can't turn to things if the things that you are creating are in this high-flying vibration and you're over here in disappointment. You're not going to get any thoughts turning to things under those conditions. Thoughts can't turn to things unless you're up here in the vibration of where the things that you're wanting and the thoughts that are about them are on the same vibrational level. You've got to be up there where you can receive them in the same way that you would tune your radio dial in your vehicle. Can't set your radio dial on 98.7 and hear what's being broadcast on 101. In other words, the frequencies have to match up. And you can't have your dial set on disappointment while everything that you've created set on joy and ecstasy and appreciation and love and have any transfer of thought. That's why you're disappointed. Who you really are is up here, and who you're being right now isn't, you see. So you got to find some way. You have to be creative about it. You got to find some way of being happy anyway. You got to stop needing something to change so that you can have a good feeling response to it. You got to figure out how to be happy before it happens. That's what we mean by getting out ahead of it. You have to get out ahead of it. And we know for sure that this knowledge, this understanding that you are gathering here and have gathered even before you got here, but that is being amplified with this conversation. We know for sure that your understanding of the processes that we are talking about, of the laws of the universe, will put you in a place of heightened expectation. And that's all that is required. Just a little shift in your expectation will make the difference between what manifests and how long it takes to manifest. So it sounds to you a little bit like we are eager for you to have manifestation of the things you want. We hear you say to us, Abraham, all right, I'll accept your version of the vortex. I can't see it or hear it or smell it or taste it or touch it, but I believe you, sort of. I'll accept that it's there, but just tell me, how can I get my money out of the vortex and into the bank? How do I turn those vibrations into thoughts and those thoughts into things? And we say, this is how. You find the feeling place of what you want. If you're wanting an extra $2,000 or $3,000 or $4,000 or $5,000 or $6,000 or $7,000 or $8,000 or $900,000 and you want it like right away, it's not likely that it's going to land in your bank account by the end of this gathering. But by the end of this gathering, you can have accomplished a feeling of prosperity. And if you can accomplish a feeling of prosperity by looking at the abundance that is evident in your life, both the financial abundance and the lifestyle abundance, and the ease abundance, and the clarity abundance, and the friendship abundance, and the magnificent planet abundance. In other words, there is so much abundance that you could focus upon. Or you could just stop, and this is the thing that we want you to understand, what unconditional love and unconditional clarity and unconditional alignment, what they are all about, it's much simpler than trying to find conditions that line up. Because for every condition that you want, there's a condition that you don't want. And then you get in this sifting and sorting of conditions and you kind of get lost, especially in the beginning if your vibration isn't really clear. But you could close your eyes And you could focus on your breathing, or you could count slowly, or you could listen to a ticking of a clock, or watch the flicker of a flame, or listen for the squeal in the condenser of the air conditioner. You could focus upon something that required a little bit of concentration, not a lot. And as you focus upon something that requires a little bit of concentration, you will release resistant thought and your vibration will rise. And as your vibration rises, you will be in the vibrational frequency of your inner being. You will be in what we are calling the receptive mode. And if you would do that every day, if you would just sit for 15 or 20 minutes and just quiet your mind, it might take 13 minutes to quiet your mind. The earlier in the day you sit to do it, the better, because you don't have so many things already moving through your mind. But if you would sit to do it, Esther sat this morning, and within a minute or so, she was right up there. She could feel that high-flying place. And for just a moment, she thought, this is the place of no thought. This is the place of no thought. And she just sat in that satisfying feeling, that satisfying feeling of no thought that was taking her away from who she really is. The satisfying feeling, a satisfying feeling of liquid love and absolute clarity and absolute and utter well-being. That feeling of connection to who you really are. And of course, we don't want you to meditate all day. We don't want you to even meditate more than 20 minutes. If you knew how much you wanted to be in these bodies, you wouldn't be trying to get out of them all the time. You want to be in these physical bodies, and you want to be experiencing the clarity of this time-space reality. But in order to get out ahead of it vibrationally, you got to find some way to, we're going to use funny words that we don't mean, break the evil spell of the momentum of the thoughts that you've been thinking, because it's sort of like you've got a tiger by the tail. Or the tiger's got you by the tail. Sometimes you've got thoughts going and it feels like you just can't stop those thoughts, but you can. And the more you relax into your natural well-being, the more your vibration will shift, and then a wonderful thing happens. On same subjects, you have access to different thoughts around those subjects. Every subject is like a stick with two ends on it, and on one end is wanted and on the other end is absence of wanted, and there's something all in between, and you have a vibrational proclivity on every subject in the world. Everything that you think about, you're vibrating somewhere on that stick, but your inner being is all the way over, or in the example of high energy, at the top of this vibrational stick. And you're somewhere. When you meditate, you'll begin to move up on every subject to the place where the better feeling thoughts are what are moving through your mind. And then a marvelous thing happens to you. Law of attraction shows you the evidence of your movement, the evidence of your point of attraction movement. You can accomplish in a short morning like the one that we will have together today, an entirely different vibrational set point than you started the day out in. Now, for many of you, you're already high flying much of the time. But all of you, this connection to source is not like a college diploma or degree where once you get it, it's yours forevermore. You're either aligned or you're not in the moment. It's a steady, ongoing, in the now relationship between the opinion or perspective of your inner being about what you're thinking about and your perspective about what you're looking at. So if you don't like somebody, you're out of agreement with your inner being. If you don't like yourself, you're out of agreement with your inner being. If you are down on yourself, you're out of agreement with your inner being. If you're down on somebody else, you're out of agreement with your inner being. It is our wish for you that you mind your own business. And your only business is whether you are in high-flying relationship with who you really are, or whether you've pinched yourself off to some degree for some unnecessary, that's the kindest word we could think of, unnecessary, stupid reason. By stupid, we mean not really thought through, not looking at it from your best perspective, not paying attention to what you're doing. But now you know too much. You will never feel negative emotion again and not know why. What do you want to talk about?